Hi folks, this is Warbird566 and today I'm back with some older footage of my FMS aka airfield Spitfire. I didn't have time to edit the video, or in other words, some other projects had higher priorities. As some of you guys might remember, in my last video I complained about the durability of the Spitz landing gear. And now 3.8 hours of flight time and 45 takeoffs and landings later, I'm back to tell you that the gear actually broke. Which was not really unexpected. It was not the gear itself or the electric that broke down. No, it was the gear mount inside the wing that gave way. So I started to build some new mounts, this time some that hopefully will hold a little bit longer. And while I'm at it, I thought it could be a nice idea to install some flaps as well. I choose to go with a simple version of split flaps, so I began work on this mod a few months ago. As you can see in the pictures, that didn't went that bad. So after one or two afternoons of work, the Spit was ready for flight again. I was a bit worried because the flying weight went up to 2000 grams, but after taking off I found out that that was not a problem. He still handled very nice in the air. The only problem I had were the flap actually. To be honest, I couldn't find a setting that was very good for landing, and believe me, I tried several settings. So I guess I have to work on that again. After a few test landings and even one almost crash while testing the flaps, I decided to leave it at that. The landing you see now is without flaps, and not all of them were that smooth. Some were actually pretty rough, a more or less controlled crash if you know what I mean. Still, the gear mount seemed to hold, at least for now, 15 takeoffs and landings so far and no sign of damage. So this should be it, I hope you enjoyed the short video. If you have any questions about the plane or the modifications I made, just leave a short note and I try to answer it. Have fun at the flying field guys, Warbird 566 out.